How do I stay up to date about mycotoxins in feed materials? You can track the mycotoxin contamination of feed and raw commodities by testing the samples, checking the Biomin mycotoxin survey, and contacting your local Biomin representative. I am going to talk about testing for mycotoxins and how to access the Biomin mycotoxin survey to stay up to date about mycotoxin occurrence. Because mycotoxins negatively impact the health and profitability of farm animals, it is really crucial to stay informed about contamination levels. Grain quality matters when formulating the feed. Knowing the actual mycotoxin status of your feedstuff is as important as knowing its basic nutritional values like protein and also energy levels. This knowledge helps you when purchasing grains, when choosing the most cost-effective feed additive to protect your animals and your profits. Feed millers and also farmers typically use on-site testing, external analytical services, or a combination of those two parts of the mycotoxin detection and risk management programs. No matter the method, a correct sampling plan is the basis for reliable results. Did you know that correct sampling is crucial for getting reliable mycotoxin test results? That is why it is really important to follow a proper sampling procedures. Both the FAO and also the EU offers full step-by-step guidelines for sampling to ensure a correct testing. We have created a practical guide to help you to succeed with sampling and get more accurate results. You can get the sampling procedure guide on biomin.net or from your local Biomin representative. To get a representative sample, it is really important to collect a great number of incremental samples from everywhere in the lot and also from different heights in order to have the complete picture. In day-to-day operations, testing each batch of cereals for mycotoxins can be impractical or cost prohibitive. Fortunately, you can stay informed of mycotoxins occurrence levels by consulting the Biomin Mycotoxin Survey, which is really the largest and most comprehensive and reputable database of mycotoxin occurrence globally. Since 2004, we have been working closely with customers throughout the globe to analyze the feed and also the raw commodity samples for the presence of mycotoxins. The Biomin Mycotoxin Survey focuses on feed materials such as corn, wheat, barley, rice, soybean meal, corn gluten meal, DDGS, and silage. More than 18,000 samples are collected year-round from over 80 countries and tested for the 6 major mycotoxins: aflatoxins, seralenone, deoxynivalenol, T2 toxin, fumonisins, and ochratoxin. We then report a risk assessment for each farm animal species based on the official guidance levels and also on scientific studies. One pattern that we consistently observe year after year is that the majority of samples tests positive for 2 or even more mycotoxins. This co-contamination is really dangerous because of the toxicity of a single mycotoxin can be greatly increased by the presence of other mycotoxins, and official recommendations may not take this into account. The Global Biomin Mycotoxin Survey is published quarterly. It is important to track mycotoxin levels regularly and not just rely on after-harvest results, because mycotoxin formation can occur during storage. You can access the Biomin Mycotoxin Survey at biomin.net or download it from the app to your smartphone. For a more detailed assessment and support with mycotoxin risk management, please contact your local Biomin representative. If you are on social media, you can find us on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, WeChat, and also on Instagram. Fun fact, mycotoxins cannot contaminate the internet.